Hi, this is Gail from Life in Splatters, and this is an interesting piece that I've been working on for quite some time. Thus far, I've done 3 installments of paint to it. So I flooded the canvas with an iridescent pearl mixed with some white, and now I'm putting on a thin line of silver paint, which I have mixed quite thin with Floetrol and water. And then I'm going to spray it with water and tilt, and let's let the paint drip down. So now I'm adding, I think it's an Amsterdam blue-gray, really pretty soft periwinkle color to it. I added some iridescent silver just to help it marry better with the silver paint. And I spray again and tilt the paint down the canvas. Having this be the first time I've tried this, there's an element of fear and experimenting. Of course you don't want to fail. Of course you don't want to make a mistake by adding the wrong colors. So I get brave and I add some more paints and spray them with water and tilt them down the canvas. I let this dry for several days, and now we're going to add some more color. And in this case, I've chosen a really beautiful, rich royal blue metallic. It's Modern Masters Venetian Blue. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to add a few little spots, spray with water, and let it drip. Thank you. Here it is, dried and waiting for the next stage, which I'm about to tackle. I know this needs more. I do like it the way it is, but I'm going to be brave and add one more color. And I've chosen a beautiful iridescent gold, a really rich yellow gold. Again, mixed with Floetrol and water to a relatively thin consistency. But I found that I had to massage the paint with the water to help it to move. And it probably has to do with the amount of mica in iridescent gold paint. So you can see how that line seemed to be reluctant to move. More water helped, but eventually just taking my finger and massaging and loosening up the pigment helped. So I'm just about to add a little more gold on this edge. And my reason for doing that is there is a rule or a tool of composition that says that an odd number of things in a painting or an image is far more pleasing than an even number. And so there were four segments that showed the gold, and just to balance it out, I took one more piece off to the left there, which, as you can see, does, it works in the composition. So I'm very pleased with this. I'm going to continue to let the paint run down, and then I'm going to let this dry a couple more days. So this painting is still at this stage, and I'm waffling a little bit about whether it needs something more, and then I look at it carefully, and I think I just like it the way it is. A simple color palette. Sometimes it's hard to know when to stop. I could easily add some black to it for a little more contrast, but actually, my eye says it's okay the way it is. So I've started another one, which I'm going to show a little piece of it at the end. And I'm using a little different color palette. And we'll see how that one goes. I hope I've inspired you to try something a little different. I want to thank you so much for all your kind words and comments. Thank you for subscribing. If you haven't, please do. I try to do 2 videos a week. And I try to come up with some unique ideas. It's not easy. Everything's been done. So, but if this one's intrigued you, give it a try. Again, let's keep playing with pigments and making beautiful things. Take care. Bye.